morning, good afternoon, and good evening, whenever and wherever you and welcome back to the Beat Up Plans. We return to Vampire the Masquerade, the final nights. In the last episode, we freed ourselves of Finblood. I cannot stand to see one of the kindreds be captured by kind. And so I released her. And though I tried to push her buttons, well, you cannot pluck a chicken that's already been plucked. But it certainly worked on Trip, and he showed me to, well, a buddy of his who can teach me and some of the more covert skills that I have yet to learn in my human life as well. In order to placate him and perhaps get some better prizes, we have picked up a little task for him to do. He was looking for, well, a mean mofo, if you forgive me the expression. And seeing I am a vampire, I think I qualify. Now, if I may break character there for a moment, I actually kind of like this a lot about this mod just already. The fact that I need not ask what his problem was, and could just skip this fight if I wanted to, or perhaps could do it later. That is an awesome addition to this mod, where in the anti-tribal mod you were almost, well, kind of forced to take certain fights. That's not really what I enjoyed about that, and here we can do whenever we want. Now, of course, I picked it out right now because, well, I'm just too curious. So let us see what we are dealing with here. One, two. Oh, we're two, right? Yeah, two. Four of them. Can we sneak up a little bit on him? Yes or no? Yes, we can. Is that guy holding a gun? Boom! Mine open! Well, and you know what? I think the blood of the sinner here works wonders. Yep, he has a gun. And he is down and out for a count. Do you guys dare and come inside? Come on, I'm ready. I can find you with a slap your ass around if you want to. You don't see me? There we go. Come on. I have Blood of the Sinner active. I want some blood. I am having some difficulty, for some reason I am not hitting this guy. Goodbye. That was kinda weird. Ow. What the? Thank you. Come on inside over here. Ah! There we go. That's what I needed. Using our Blood of the Sinner, and if you don't know what it is, it gives me additional nourishment if I drink from, well, those that have sinned. It's kind of easy. The name says it all now, doesn't it? And in this case, it allows me to kick ass! Well, actually, it doesn't really give me any combat bonuses, but it just allows me to drain their blood dry. There we go, and we even found ourselves, well, with a much more powerful gun! Containing 18 bullets! Ooh, look at that! I think it's also way more accurate. I think so. I kinda like that. Very good. Well, there was our first fight. I do have to admit that I kinda abused the AI there, having trouble to navigate around the corner in order to get to me, but well. What can I say? You gotta use every advantage available. So let us see what we have as selection now that we have garnered some favor with this man, this Jimmy Reed. With the most atrocious accent that I've ever heard in my entire life and unlife.
Yo, dog.
Hey, Jimmy. I have something to tell you. You got a minute?
Sure, man, go ahead.
I took care of your gang problem.
Hell yeah, I got 2 clients in less than 1 hour. Haven't had that in like 4 months. I don't know what you did, I don't know how you did it, but hell yeah. What I promised you is in the arcade slot. You got Jimmy Reed's everlasting, eternal gratitude for at least a month.
Thanks. Well, I've got a question for you, I must say.
Sure, man, go ahead.
I would like to see your selection, if I may.
Yeah, take what you need, man.
Thank you. So what do we have a selection? A way to increase our dodge and a way to increase our gun skill. We are using that. And a way to increase our stealth skill. Well, I don't think that's really needed. And a way to increase our computer skill. Top of that, brawl, which is actually the way we want to go when we are fighting the kind. The kindred. For kind, we use guns, but we need 2 of that. It's a bit expensive, though. Security, that's for opening locks. Research, you need at least a research of 6 to use this item. That's quite a bit. It requires me to have better research. Wait a second. Knife fighting, that's probably for melee. And this is financial ability. Well, that's for a haggle. Well, you know what? I kind of want to save him money for this big thing when we can use later, but you know what? Let us buy the computers for Grant. And we'll exit. And then we'll use some of our press's experience to gain some computer skill, because now it only costs 2 points. Next one will cost 3 points. However, the books always give you, well, either the 1st or 2nd point, or the 3rd or 4th point, or the 5th point. So you always want to have them on the even number, because if we read it now, my stat has been increased up to here. And I would never be able to have done so if I already had the 2nd option. So now our hacking all of a sudden is at level 4. It's probably not enough yet to do everything that we want to, but it certainly will have helped. There we go. Now, as we've dealt with that gang of miscreants, all drooped and doped up that they cannot even slur out a sensible sentence, it is time to deal perhaps with the ones that, well, roughed up Mercurio. And they were through this chain fenced link, so we were told. Let us see if these guys have a little bit more class, and if we can talk to them. The bouncer doesn't bode well, but alright.
Help ya?
Relax. I'm here to buy. You know what from. Well, you know, right?
Okay, you can go on. And if you really want to make my night, go ahead and start some shit in there, because I would love it.
I'll remember that. Thank you. Let us go through the front door. Another man. At least we're going to scope out what is up in here. 2 people over here. I reckon that if I would try to open their chest, they would get angry. Hacking of 4. Hang 10. Entering email. Keep your board riding smooth. Shark loop keeps your board riding smooth when things get wet. Right. Server thing. Menu, please. Quit on this one. How about the online banking? I'm not sure hacking of 4 will give me enough leverage. No, it does not. Alright, well, quit. Nobody's angry with me yet. That's good. That's like a huge grade over here.
real good at me. Before we do business, before anything changes hands, I want you to hear this. If you try to cross me, I will fuck you. If you tell the cops about me, I will find you. Then I will fuck you. And if you are a cop, I will fuck you and your whole family, including that squirrel in your front yard. Now that we know the terms, what can I do to make you walk out feeling like you just flew first class with a cheerleader in your lap?
Well, what do you got for sale?
My staff maintains at all times a 24-karat smuggler's board of A-plus narcotics guaranteed to make the competition shit seem like a weak cappuccino in comparison. White, green, blues, reds, black, pick a color.
Well, actually, I'm looking for something different. Do you have anything in the form of explosives?
Explosives? Fun stuff. You can get yourself a lot of attention that way. I may have something. Why would you need to get your hands on some fireworks?
Money issues. I need to make a car disappear for the insurance.
Sure, okay. I got some stuff that'll do the trick. Astrolite. It's like TNT's bigger, meaner cousin with a prison record. I don't like keeping the stuff around. Too dangerous. So I'll let you have it for a little less than the going rate.
Well, I just said I need to get some insurance money. Look, I'm good for the money. Believe me, I'd never rip off a guy like you. I mean, after all, you would even fuck the squirrel in my front yard, right?
You sure you're good for it? Because all it means to me if you're not is a little late night shark fishing trip with the boys, if you understand what I'm saying. Hey, you hold on to it. But if you don't pay me, your life is shit. Understand?
Yes, I understood. I'll bring the money as soon as I can. Goodbye. Thank you for doing business. What the hell is up with this? I know. Something tells me that was the original money for the Astrolite. Let us not bother the guys that play in cars. That man is busy watching a little bit of a game, and this is a way to escape past that guy unseen. And possibly, well, who knows, we could use it. They might get a little confused. As I said, doing business is what I always did in life. Very good, we got the Astrolite, and I guess I will have to find myself a reason for some altruism. After all, getting on the good side of the ghoul of, well, the man that ordered the death of my sire, is probably a good idea. I would reckon that he is powerful. Perhaps that trip fellow has something, but I wouldn't mind taking another little gander around the hospital. In fact, if we want to have a little bit more inspection, it might not be bad. Costs 8. How unfortunate. I would have enjoyed a little bit of that. Do we have any quests that we can still solve before the jumping the rail? No. Haven't been able to get in there. We have that. We got that. Pyramid of Deception? Nope. Carnival of Death? No. Okay, so all we can do is a needful Mercurio, and as we haven't increased our inspection, I doubt we will be able to do anything about that. And now that this man will give me more money, we could ask him.
Where is that damn tow truck?
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. Well, I hope it will all be better. Perhaps you would like a little company, however, in the meantime.
I'm happily married to my work, and I have a wife, too.
Yeah, that's not what I meant, but see. Jeez, man. Can a man not stand together with a man and immediately be something? What all are you? Homophobic?
Thanks for coming back. What you need?
Oh, don't look at me like that. I like to buy something this time.
Alright, here's what we got today.
Sell you this, but I actually will buy that morphine bottle you have. I'm not selling yet the Smith & Wesson, because we don't have that many bullets for the clock. So I think that might be a misplay if we do so. And let us get ourselves to Mercurio. You really need to call up your cleaners. Oh, damn, did you die on me? Ugh, good. Look, I brought you some morphine. Hold still.
Oh, holy Christ, I needed that.
Well, you're welcome. Anyways, I got the astrolite.
Yeah? Did you waste those sons of bitches?
No. That wasn't needed.
Did you get my money back?
Yes, matter of fact, I did. I guess you want it back. Well, you better remember this.
Ah, you're a lifesaver. I might have to buy some new kidneys with this.
So, what's the story with this astrolite?
That astrolite? Twice as powerful as TNT. Instant demolition. Be on the other side of the world when you engage that timer. You need to make someplace disappear. A warehouse. Looks to be a Sabbat interest.
I see, and how do I find this place?
There's a guy. I never met him, but I heard a lot about him. His name is Tong. Bertram Tong. He's one of you types. If there's anyone who knows more than me about this city, it's him. Unfortunately, Tong's hiding out at the moment.
And is there anyone else who wouldn't know?
If there are, I don't know him. But about this Tong, Tong's laying low because of Therese. Therese Vorman, you know her? Anyway, word is Therese and Tong are feuding. I don't know the details. Mike takes that Tong thinks he's about to get whacked, so he's gone underground till Therese calls it off. If you want to put that warehouse into orbit anytime soon, you're gonna have to get Therese to call off the feud.
I see, and where can I find this Therese Vorman?
She and her sister Jeanette, they run the asylum. Some freaky customers frequent that place. I try not to do business there.
What can you actually tell me about Jeanette?
Therese I don't like, but I can respect her. Jeanette's different. I don't know what to make of her. She's a little, you know, in the head. I don't know. Therese is, well, like you. And I would think so's Jeanette. But I hear rumors about her.
Rumors?
Alright. Jeanette got a body built for bedrooms. And I got close acquaintances says they conquered that territory. But I asked the main man, and he says you types, you know, can't or don't or do that kind of thing. Anyway, whatever she is, I hear Jeanette's a wild girl.
Alright, I had a question actually.
Who
about
exactly?
A sister. Well, Therese Vorman.
She's the woman around here. Power player. Nice looking broad for a dead chick, but personality like stone.
See, I assume I can find her in the asylum?
She and her sister Jeanette, they run the asylum. Some freaky customers frequent that place. I try not to do business there.
Well, I'll guess I go see her then. Goodbye. Well, I guess the Vorman sisters are the next link in the chain, if you will. But first, I would like to inspect a little closer in the surrounding areas of that, well, house near my place. Supposedly, that is where this Marianne Marietta lives. And I'm ever curious about it, to be honest. Is there no way for us to enter? How difficult is this lock? I can't remember. 5. It's quite a bit. Now, I think with a new gained experience, yeah, we could actually raise perception, which normally is definitely not the way I would go. And I would kind of like to increase presence, because it gives a passive bonus to intimidation and seduction. Which is awesome, because, well, we also would like to increase those skills. So a good try to go in for perception one more, because it also gives us more range skills. And then we could see if we could find the key over here, which normally lies around this area. But, well, as you can see, I'm clicking now on the use button, but there is nothing there. Let's see if we have another email. Actually, we do. A favor. It has come to our... Shoot. I, by accident, hit the D button and deleted it. Well, I cannot read the email for you, but... I can do this. LaCroix has contacted you through email and given you the task of retrieving a vial of werewolf blood from the medical clinic to protect the masquerade. Well, I'm sure that will pay handsomely, so... Why don't we go and try and focus on that? Moreover, now that we have hacking skills, perhaps some of those lovely files in... Well, the doctor's offices are now up for grabs. Which I wouldn't mind at all reading a little bit into. And I don't want to waste the experience points either, because I have the suspicion that, well... We may need to open a door or two, and for that we will need... Pick lock. Well, at least the girl that we saved is gone. Very handy. Now, were we able to get everything from this area? I do think we read on personnel. But did we read the emails? Yeah, I remember the password Dodgers. Actually, we didn't. Then I must have remembered the password from actually before. Strange blood sample. Hey Danny, we received an interesting blood sample from someone over at the Sun. I guess some freak told him it was werewolf blood. Can you believe that shit? Anyway, they're paying us to run the numbers, so could you do it for your next shift? Many thanks, F-Dog. Actually, I'm certain we read about the mother and F-Dog. Blood test. How the hell am I supposed to know what you're testing for? Get creative. It's really not a big deal. But just see if there's anything strange about it. F-Dog. Oh yeah, sorry. The sample's in the electronic cabinet in control substances. By the way, you down for some hoops this weekend? You're on thin ice. Jesus, do you know anything? I had Phil change the password a few hours ago. The new password is the name of Malcolm's dirty little secret. Oops. Did I just say that? You better leave this thing when you're done reading it. See you at the F-Park on Saturday morning. Interesting. Now we need to know about someone's dirty little secret. Malcolm, right? Yeah, then we need to enter over here. Four. Can we reach that with the cured XP? We could boost it here and... Security, right? We can even then buy the book, would be a worthy buy. Then we have lockpicking free, and then with a little blood buff, we can actually reach level 4. What does dexterity else give us? Sneaking. Well, let's first look upstairs. I don't want to waste the experience. Malcolm's dirty little secret. We will get that dirty little secret. Well, that's not too much, but... Ah, screw it. Holy heck, blood buff costs a lot of blood, to be honest. Alright. We entered. Probably want to picklock this as quick as possible with the blood buff still active. Yes, indeed. Alright. Maintenance is locked. There's a guard. Whoa! Did he see me? Oh, I must have, otherwise he wouldn't fire a shot. Hey Jason, can you reset Malcolm's password for me? I want to set to university. Well, that's the way to enter his computer, but it seems like the guard is quite potent. Perhaps increasing my sneaking wouldn't have been such a bad idea after all. Well, he's gone now. Let's just get out of here and let him say that he fired at a shadow. Well, I think we are kind of obligated to increase dexterity, along with security. Go like this, and then we can open some doors. Still can't open every other thing. Of course, we could increase our blood buff afterwards, so that we could actually open level 5 crates, and we found quite a few of them. But we can also just buy the book. Conundrums to consider. Of course, we can also just go to Therese Vorman. You know what? Let's just do that. But I think I'm getting near the end of the episode, so we might just see that in the next episode. After all, we gotta end the episode with us feeling tip-top in shape. Because I feel the hunger growing. And I do believe my little blood doll is right over here for us to make use of. Darn it, I kinda wanted to drain that guy, but then that fellow followed him into the alley. That would have been a little bit too dangerous to try out. Unwilling blood dolls are always so handy. Actually, I just remembered something. I think we've forgotten the little side quest. Let me just return for a short moment, actually, towards the hospital. I'm sorry that I'm now going in and out in there, but there is actually a site. I wonder if it is still there. After all, a little blood bank that delivers us blood is lacking in supply. And we just gained the humanity. Aren't we great?
Need a fix?
Yeah. Actually, he does not ask for us to do so. How interesting. Normally there's a little side quest where you free Lily, you can talk to the girl upstairs in the asylum and you can get her to, well, willingly, well, find herself doing very, very good deeds. I'm intrigued by the fact that the quest doesn't pop up, which also makes me wonder, should I perhaps just go up and talk to her and see what I can do?
Sheesh, is this place always so dead?
More so than you think.
I thought coming to LA was going to be more exciting than Arizona. I didn't come all this way just for watered down booze.
No, if I hear anything going on, I'll stop by and tell you. See ya. So she actually has the same dialogue, but hey.
Hey man.
Hello, Nux. What's going on?
Yeah, not much. I'm just waiting around for my master.
The master you couldn't talk about.
Okay. I guess I can tell you about it.
Oh man, his name's Bertram Tongue. He's a Nosferatu.
Nice. What is he like?
Oh man! Well, he's like the only vampire I know, but, well, he seems pretty damn powerful! Oh man! When he's looking at you, it's like he's really spinning your brain, you know? It's like tripping. It's crazy! Man! But I guess that's the Nosferatu's thing, you know? They, like, know everything!
Actually, that's not a power at all, but how does he get in touch with me?
It's crazy! He just appears out of like thin air! First time he... BAM! Give me a goddamn heart attack! Especially how he looks.
Well, that skill is not only for Nosferatu. But I agree, I still have to develop it. Nonetheless, what do you do for Bertram?
Oh man! Wow, Bertram had me keeping an eye on this guy. This Asian dude who's been poking around Santa Monica. Bertram thought he might be a vampire or something like a vampire, I don't know.
So what's the problem?
Oh man, this guy, this thing, got wise to me. Now instead of me watching him, he's watching me, you know? I see this guy appear around me all the time, like off in the distance watching me warp up next to me. Oh man, it's here.
That must be unnerving.
It's freaking me out! I know this thing is totally toying. I want to put a bullet in its head, but who knows if that'll do anything. So I was waiting till I talked to Bertram, but... Well, if I know where he disappeared to, it's messed up!
I see. So, I guess you want it taken care of.
Hell yeah! Right on! Okay, like I said, he's some kind of Asian vampire thing, you know? The only clue I got is this driver's license that he dropped once while I was tailing him. I get so freaked out that I haven't even had a chance to check it out.
Alright, I'll look into it.
Right on! Just come back and let me know the job's done so I can stop freaking out. Maybe I'll see Bertram by then.
Sounds good. I'll see you around. But first, of course, I was getting desperate until I saw you standing. You look, actually a lot like my ex-girlfriend.
Not in this lifetime.
Well, it was worth a shot. What the heck? Does her seduction requirement go up the more time you talk to her? That's really weird. But interesting. And I say, I thank you for watching, and remember, great heroes.